It's worse than it was, and it's almost like the stone being rolled right in the middle of your pathway, and it's an obstacle that you can't get over. And that sense of confusion, that sense of frustration, that sense of what's going on, that's where we come to right now here in Mark chapter 16. As we enter God's Word together, this is where we are. So in Mark chapter 16 and verse 1, it says, "When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so they could go and anoint him. Very early in the morning, on the first day of the week, they went to the tomb at sunrise." Now, of course, at this time frame, we understand that there was sundown to sundown was a day at that time frame. And so here in the moment in this life, we are Saturday night, late Saturday night. They're going and buying spices. They're getting prepared so that early Sunday morning, when the sun rose and at daybreak, they were at the tomb. And this was a typical thing that they would do. They would go and they would take care of the bodies. But let's just think about them for a moment. Let's think about where they are and what's going on. They are confused. They are sad. They might be mad. They're alone. They've got all of these emotions that are going on, and they're not sure what to do. I mean, Jesus was their everything, and now that Jesus is gone, they're not sure what to do. They don't remember all the things that he had told them. They don't remember the promises that he was coming back. And so as we are at this moment right now, I think we can identify some with what they're going through. We can identify with the loss of different things in our life and the grief that we're facing and the obstacles that we're facing. And what I want us to focus on today is let's look and see what God did for them, because you know what? That's exactly what God has done for us today. And the challenge at the end of our time is to look and see, am I moving forward with this same idea? Am I doing the things that has been done for me? Am I doing it moving forward as well? So let's look and see what God did. In verse 2, very early in the morning, on the first day of the week, they went to the tomb at sunrise. And they were saying to one another, "Who's going to roll the stone away from the entrance to the tomb for us?" Looking up, they noticed that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. And when they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. I tell you what, I don't know about you, but I think the idea of being alarmed is really that's less than probably what I would have been feeling. I think I would have been more than just alarmed. I think I would have been just completely shocked, completely dumbstruck. I'd be, you know, scared out of my mind. I wouldn't, you know, just to walk in with one expectation and to enter into a totally different expectation. I mean, the stone was gone. Jesus isn't there. A guy's standing in there. What in the world's going on? And they just don't seem to understand. And they don't know what's going on. But what I want us to see right now is that these women went up and they were absolutely worried. Who's going to move the stone away? And even before they got there, God was already working, and he removed the obstacles that were in their way. God removed the obstacle that was in their way. Do you realize how many obstacles God moves out of our way from time to time? Yes, sometimes we have to go through difficulties. Yes, we have to deal with different emotions and different experiences. But the fact that God has removed the obstacle out of our way so that we can have a relationship with Jesus Christ is absolutely tremendous. And all of any day, this day, we celebrate that reality that God has removed that obstacle from us. But it says in verse 6, "Don't be alarmed," he told them. "You're looking for Jesus of Nazareth who was crucified. He has risen. He's not here. See the place where they put him." Not only did God remove the obstacle, but we see that God, through the angels, is welcoming them into this moment. He's welcoming them into the moment. And then he's going to move on and he's going to begin to provide them instruction. You know, you're looking for Jesus. He was crucified, that's true. He was buried, that's true. But he's not here. He's not here. The tomb is empty. The stone is rolled away. The ladies are freaking out. The angel's saying, don't be panicked. Don't be alarmed, because this is exactly what was supposed to happen. God has removed the obstacle. God has welcomed them into the situation. And now he begins to teach them and provide them the information that they need. Look at the place where they put him. But go and tell the disciples and Peter, he's going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there just as he told you. So he removes the obstacle. He welcomes them in. He provides them information. And then he sends them out. He says, go. I need you to go and tell everybody and Peter. Have you ever thought that you were too far gone? Have you ever thought that you were too far on the outside? Have you ever thought that I've done one too many wrong things? God won't love me. God won't take me. God won't accept me. God won't have me. And so it doesn't matter. Two words right here make all the difference for me. Two words right here make all the difference for you. Two words. And Peter. And Peter. Go tell the disciples and Peter. In other words, go tell everybody. Go tell everybody. It doesn't matter how godly or ungodly you are. It doesn't matter how close or far away you are. It doesn't matter how religious or irreligious you are. It doesn't matter where you are on the spectrum of belief. You go and tell everybody Jesus is alive. And in that moment, we begin to sense and realize the importance of this moment right here, that he invites them to get involved. He doesn't just say, I'm going to handle it all. He says that I am going to send you and you're going to go and handle it. I want you to be a part of this entire process. I want you to come in, see what's going on, and then go out and tell everybody what's going on. And this is what we see right here. So as we move on in our scripture and our verses together, it says, go tell the disciples and Peter that he's going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there just as he told you. And so he then is going to encourage them along the way. Look, I don't want you to just go and tell, but he's going to meet you. He's going to be there, and he's encouraging them along the way. This is a tremendous moment. This is a tremendous moment as we look and see everything that is going on. I want to give you a truth today, and here's our truth today, that Jesus paid it all, and he paid it forward. Jesus paid it all, and he paid it forward. It wasn't just a once-and-done moment. It wasn't just that at that moment, in that time, that happened. But it's that he continues to pay it, and he continues to pay it forward, that the forgiveness that he offered and he gave and he sealed at the death, burial, and resurrection isn't a one-time back then. It continues to go. It continues to move on. He continues to pay it forward. God has done this for you. He's done it for you that are here. He's done it for you online. He's done it for your friends. He's done it for your family. He's done it for that person that you think is too far gone. He's done it for that person that doesn't want to have anything to do with Jesus Christ. He's done it for that person who doesn't want to believe in Jesus Christ. God has done it for everybody. For God so loved the whole world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever would believe, his sins would be forgiven, and he would be right with God, and he would have a relationship with God. Oh, they may not be ready to hear it now. They may not be ready to choose it right now, but at some point, the options continue to be available to them. God has done this for you. I want you to imagine, because, you know, none of us can go sit down in a restaurant. Many of us are going through drive-thrus, right? I mean, honk if you've been through a drive-thru in the last week. Yes, I know, right? You know, we can all raise our hand and say, yeah, I've been through a drive-thru. Honk if you've been through a drive-thru three times in the last week. I know it. I would say every day, but well, we don't want to go there. But oh, I got a honk on every day. That's awesome. So we're going through the drive-thru. Imagine that you're sitting in the drive-thru line and you pull up and you're ready to hand to get your meal and to hand the person your money or your card or whatever it is that you're using to pay for it. And usually, you know, you get there, they open the window, they go over your order, and they want to take your money. But instead, they open up the window, they go over your order, they've got all the bags sacked right there, and they hand it to you. And you're like, oh, okay, so in the process of getting all the food out, you're shifting it over to the navigator next to you, right? And you give it out, and so the one who hands everything out, you just handed it all over to them, and you turn, and you take your card or your cash or whatever you're paying with, and you turn and you want to hand it into the window, but they've closed the window. So you start knocking on the window, right? You start knocking on that window. And then they come and say, yeah, can I help you? Oh, you forgot. I need to pay you. And they say, no, you don't. Your meal's already been paid for. Now, how would that make you feel? I mean, yeah, it'd be a great day, right? That'd be an awesome day, you know, to think that you came prepared to pay, but as you received all of that food, you realized somebody else had already paid that for you. I don't know about you, but I would start smiling. I'd be great. But you know, there are some people that would say, oh, no. I'm not gonna let that happen. I can't let somebody else pay for my food. I can't let somebody else do that. You've got to take my money. And now you're just putting everybody in an awkward situation. You can try to force pay for something that's already been paid. You could just accept the gift. You could just accept the gift and be happy all the way home, right? That's probably what I'd do. I'd be like, oh yeah, thank you, Jesus. My meal's paid for today. I can enjoy this meal knowing that it didn't cost me anything. It doesn't lessen my enjoyment of the meal. In fact, I think it enhances the enjoyment of that meal, right? I mean, it makes that Chick-fil-A sandwich taste so much better. So, you know, this is how the resurrection affects us. We come to this moment, people come to a moment of hearing about Jesus, and they hear that Jesus has already paid it all, and he's already paid it forward. And so you're moving up in the spiritual line, and you're coming, and you want to receive the forgiveness of God, but you think, no, I've got to pay for that. So I have to do enough good works to outweigh my bad works. I've got to make sure that I step up and I do all the right things at all the right times. When God's sitting there at the drive-thru handing it out saying, no, it's already paid for. I just need you to take it. I just need you to accept that it's already been paid for. That's a tremendous moment when we begin to think of all that God has done. What is holding you back from faith today? What's holding you back from saying, I will accept this gift that was paid for before I ever got here? I will accept the payment of all of my life, past, present, and future. It's already been paid for, and I'm going to accept that into my heart. I'm going to accept that into my life. I'm going to take it, and I'm going to own it inside my life. And even though I thought I had to pay, I don't have to pay. It's already been paid. Jesus paid it all, and he's paying it forward. God stands ready to welcome you, to provide information, to invite you to do all these same things for you. He wants to do them for you. He's removed the obstacles. He's provided the information. He's welcoming you in. He's calling you, if you've already placed your faith in Christ, he's calling you to go and tell those around and Peter, to tell everybody what's going on. And trust me, he's going to encourage you along the way. But I want us to go back to that drive-thru for a moment, because there's another option. There's another option that I didn't go over. You know, maybe you're broke. Maybe you've lost your job. Maybe you don't have it to give right now. And you were desperate and you were tired and you were going to go eat anyway. And so you didn't have the money, but you were going to pay for that and just deal with it later, right? And so you could just go home and you could be blessed. And maybe you've got the money to pay. Maybe you've got the money to pay. And we think about this in real life. Somebody paid for you. And now you are receiving that. What are you going to do? Maybe you don't have the money. Go home and be blessed. Maybe you've got the money. And what could you do? You could say, how much is the guy behind me? How much is the guy behind me? Because I want to pay. It was paid for me. I want to provide for somebody else. As was given to me, I want to give it away to somebody else. This is how the resurrection affects you as a believer today. You've received payment, and you can now go and tell somebody else. And as you have accepted it, you can give it away to somebody else, and you can help somebody else understand what to do. You, as a believer in Christ, you also, it is our job to remove the obstacles to our family and our friends and our neighbors and our workmates and our classmates and our Zoom mates, as it is today. As we see people in all kinds of spaces and places, it's our job now to remove the obstacles and to help people be prepared to understand who Jesus is. And the best way to help somebody understand who he is to let Jesus live through us today so people can see Jesus in us. People can see him in us. Are we setting up or tearing down the obstacles for others to come to faith in Jesus Christ? Let us be doing the things of God and removing the obstacles for our friends and our family. Let us welcome people into our life. Let's encourage people. Let's provide the information that they need. They say, I don't understand it. Help them understand it. Well, I don't think it's for me. Help them understand how much it's for them. Well, I don't think God could ever love me. Show them how much God can love them. Reveal that to them, help them, encourage them, and invite them to become a part of the process. We at First Baptist Church, we love people so they can move forward in their life journey. Wherever it is that they are on, whatever point they're on, they may be far away from Jesus, but we're going to love them so they can move forward in their life journey. They may be right on the brink of accepting Jesus Christ, and we're going to love them all the way across that line. And they may have accepted Jesus Christ yesterday or the day before or years ago, and we are going to love you that we can keep moving down the line on our journey until we get to be with God until the very end of time. We love people so they can move forward on their life journey. And so I ask you, how can you love somebody today? Think about everybody that you have some contact with, some opportunity to talk with. How can you love them today so they move forward in their life journey? This is what God did. Jesus paid it all, and he paid it forward. Jesus paid for you. Let us pay it forward. Let us take what we've been given, all the blessings that we have in the love and forgiveness and this journey we have with Jesus, and continue to pay it forward. How can you love somebody else today? How can you share the love that you've received with somebody else? How can you see people come to faith in Christ? Jesus paid it all, and he paid it forward. And that's the challenge for us today. As the band comes and we prepare to sing a song of meditation, a song of reflection, we realize that Jesus paid it all. We realize that Jesus paid it forward. But do we realize that now he's calling us who have received it all to give it away? Will you pay it forward today? Will you take this celebration and pay it forward? Will you take your new realization and pay it forward? Will you take the blessing and will you give it away to those around us? You may be here today online, or you may be in person, and you are realizing that you need to step forward in this moment with Christ, and you need to understand in new ways, and you need to commit in new ways. We encourage you online just to put it in the chat box to make sure that you write down, I'm making my first time commitment in Jesus Christ today, or I'm making my commitment to walk deeper and better with him. I realize that he's paid it all, and I want to pay it forward. Those of you that are here today, we're going to take a moment of reflection. You can also get on your phone and text or message us and let us know, I'm making a first-time commitment to accept and believe that Jesus Christ paid it all for me. Maybe you're here today and you recognize, I also want to make the commitment to pay it forward. Jesus paid it all. Will we pay it forward today? Let's pray.